that's the phasing discussion. So that's the week after that. Oh yes, it's going to be easy. It's almost Christmas.
Probably
want to
talk about the habitat
for people. They want to talk about that. So, and the phasing will be a pretty good discussion. So that's on the 13th. And so we're sort of aiming to have a collective sense for the JPA maybe by next week. There may be some tweaks or changes, but that would then go forward to be finalized and go to the next stage in the process.
Yeah.
The other item really is this transition plan language, which I know is linked with the habitat formula discussion. You know, we're hoping to bring that transition plan language as soon as possible to the board, because there are other, as you saw in the presentation, Kendall, that there's other components, not just habitat, that need to be addressed. So as soon as we can have that, if the habitat formula, if everybody loves what we get next Friday, and people want to give that a recommendation for the board, that would be great. If not, we'll keep it on. So maybe what we'll do is we'll put habitat formula, JPA draft language, and transition plan language on the agenda if we can get to it next week. And if not, we'll have to take it up again the following week until we can get it done.
So you just addressed what I wanted to be sure was on the agenda, is that this group, at least from the maker of the motion that we just passed in this discussion, was that we're trying to set forth the formula that if the HCP doesn't happen, that there's an equitable formula for the distribution or application of the $17 million, and that be set by the FORA board, and it will be incorporated in the HCP. So if we have to, if we're looking at this, and then March 13th is the transition plan, the transition plan changes are coming in front of the FORA board, I would at least like that we're making an action item that's on the agenda of a recommendation where we may not have a formula, that we're directing the FORA board that the transition plan will be modified to state that FORA will pass this money to a JPA if it's created. And if not created, there will be an equitable formula that they can approve next month or whenever that is. But the concept is in there. And that the delegation of funds to the JPA will also include the distribution. That I would like to have that's in the JPA, obviously, that distribution. That's in front of the FORA board March 13th. It needs to be there as a placeholder so we can get this going, in my opinion. And this group's going to continue to negotiate what that formula is, but that's just a tagline that would be added in April or whatever.
So the board meeting is, reminder, on the 12th,
oh,
Thursday, and then the special meeting of the board is the following Friday. So it's possible that we could, if this group can come up with language where, and I appreciate that we're trying to move things quickly. That's kind of what we tried to do with this EIR thing, but I think it worked a little clumsy in terms of having a discussion and an hour later having it to the board and getting this action. So ideally, this group could come up with a recommendation on the 13th, which could then be brought to the board in a special meeting the following week.
And if I may, one of the things with the, there are a number of issues in the transition plan, not just the habitat group. I know that we're very focused on that. But it would not be surprising to me if we have a report on the transition plan with, you know, elements 1 through 10 on the 12th, and then come back with the habitat on the following week. But you're absolutely correct. The idea is to match the transition plan, the JPA agreement, all these things so they're consistent, and then to get an adopted piece, but to only pass it once, you know, one time for a 2020 rather than to be constantly making amendments. And I think, you know, based on that, we're going to try to get the draft out sooner rather than later so that councils can have an opportunity to look at that and make sure that they're fully aware of what's being proposed.
And I think the point that Gail was making was that there be language in the draft that goes to the board in advance of the March 12th meeting that reflects that this
yes.
discussion is happening and kind of the place for things to
right.
get plugged in, so that then when we have what's going to get plugged in,
so the table
the board
be
knows
TBD.
That it's coming and it will be a...
Yep.
Yeah, the concept is in there.
We just have to leave the...
Yeah,
yes.
You don't have the actual table, because that's exactly what's going to the FORA board. All of our jurisdictions are trying to have discussions about it. You're also circulating in front of us our transition plan implementing agreements that you want us to review. I want to be sure that the transition, as the representative Marina, is that that is superior to the transition plan and been consistent, but it'd be nice if everything was consistent. So my attorneys in the city of Marina are trying to look at all these things, and they need to mirror and match immediately.
Yes.
Okay, so we've got a little bit of road mapping done here and some sense that we need to have good discussions and make decisions. I think we're on a good track there. And with that, I think we should safely adjourn.
Oh, yeah, as soon as he goes.